Hello guys, welcome to another video in the series of coding. Today we are going to do another problem that is called bipartite graph. So you are given an adjacency list of a graph of vertices having zero base intersection. You have to check whether the graph is bipartite or not. So let's see what is the meaning of bipartite graph. So let's say you have some graph like this, right? Okay. If I tell you, you have to arrange, okay, the graph such that, let's say you are able to give one color here. Let's say you are giving the color red here. Okay. Then you are giving the color blue here. Then you can give the color red here. So no two adjacent nodes should have the same color. Okay. So that is bipartite graph. Okay. So no two adjacent nodes should have the same color. So if you are giving one node as the red color, then another node will be blue. Then next node will be red. Okay. So this is a bipartite graph. Okay. So a bipartite graph is such that it can be colored in two colors, right? Overall, you can just use two colors and color the entire graph. Then it is a bipartite graph. Okay. What if now, if I, let's say, add this here, add a node here. Then is it bipartite? Can it remain bipartite? No, because see, this node is also red colored. This node is also red colored, right? So in this case, how can two neighbors have the same color? They cannot have, right? What if you try to change the color? What if you make it blue? Then this is blue, this is also blue. These two will have a problem, right? These two will again have a problem because two neighbors cannot have the same color. So this is not, okay, not a bipartite graph. What if you have some other graph? Okay, let's just take some other graph. Some graph like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, something like this. 6, 7, 8, something like this. Okay, so now, is this a bipartite graph or not? Let's see. Suppose let's start coloring, okay? Let's color here red. Okay, let's give it green. Let's just take any two colors. I'm just taking randomly two colors. Then again red, then green, then red. Now, see again, this is a problem, right? Because if these two nodes are going to get the same color, so it will not remain bipartite. If I try to change the color and make it green, it will not remain bipartite because these two nodes will have the same color, okay? So this is not a bipartite graph, okay? This is not a bipartite graph. What if now instead I had something like this? Is it a bipartite graph? This will be red, green, red, green. I can give it different colors, right? And then what about this graph? This is also red, green, red. I can give it some other colors. So this entire graph is also a bipartite graph, right? There is no problem because you can partition it into two nodes, right? So it's easily partitionable. So it will be a bipartite graph. Okay, now what is the algorithm to solve this? So the algorithm is going to be simple, right? Which is used to deduct cycle BFS or DFS. We can simply use a BFS or DFS. It's going to be very simple. Okay, let's see the algorithm. Let me show it in this here itself. Let's say we have some graph like this. Okay, 11, 13, 15, something like this. Okay, now let's find out if it's a bipartite graph or not. Let's say we are starting the BFS from this. So we'll start the BFS from this. Okay, let's give it some color. Let's say we are giving it red color. We'll go to the next node and let's say we are giving it green color. Okay, let's do the BFS. Okay, let's first do BFS, then we'll do DFS, and then we'll see the code of this algorithm. So first we start and give the node 11. Okay, it is having the color of red. Okay, node 11 is having the color red. Okay, so we have pushed node 11 and we have given it color red. Now what we'll do, we'll pop it out and we'll push its neighbors and give them color. So we will give the node 6, which is its neighbor, green color. Okay, now let's go forward. Now we'll pop this also and we will push its neighbors and give them opposite colors. Okay, so they are not colored right now. So they are not colored. So let's say we have a color vector, okay, which is going to color. So color vector will be something like this. It will just have color at each of the positions. Okay, so 0, 1. So what are the color vectors here? For simplicity, let me just write out the node values. 6, 11, 7, 8, okay, 9, 10, 13, 15. Okay, 9, 10, 13, 15. Let's say these are the node values. Then in this case, okay, now what is the next node which we are going to push? We have taken out 6 and we'll push its neighbors. Okay, before that, let me just color red as 11 as red and let me color 6 as green. Okay, we have given two colors. Now let's see the next. Next we have 7. Okay, next we have 7 and 7 is going to get pushed. So we'll give it opposite color. It's not having any value, so we can simply give it red color. Okay, so we'll give 7 as red color. We'll take 9 and we'll also give it red color. Okay, we'll take 9, we'll give it red color, and we'll push both in the queue. Now what we'll do, we'll pop 7 and R. Okay, we'll pop 7 and R. Okay, and what are we going to do? Once we pop 7 and red, okay, we'll give color to its neighbor. So first of all, we'll check its neighbor 6. It has two neighbors, 6 and 8, right? Its neighbor 6 is having green color. So it's fine because it's having opposite color. So it's okay. It's not causing any problem. We'll see the next neighbor, 8. 8 is not having any color. So what we will do? 8 is not having any color at all. So we will push it in the queue. I will push it in the queue and I will give it green color. Okay. I should give it opposite color, right? I should give it opposite color. So I will push 8 and I will give it green color. Okay. I will give it green color. Okay. Next, what we are going to do? We are going to give it green color. Okay. Now, which do I have? I have 9 with red color. So let me take out 9. It has red color. Okay. Let me write the other notes here. Okay, I have taken out 9 and 9 is having red color. So now I will see, check the neighbors of 9. Now 9 has 3 neighbors, but neighbor 6 is having opposite color. It's having green color, right? So it's okay. It's fine. It's not a problem with us because opposite colors is what we want in a bipartite graph. But there are two neighbors which do not have any color at all. So what I will do, I will take the color of this which is red and I will give them opposite color. So I will push 10, I will push 13 and I will give them both green color. Okay, and I will... give them both green color and I will also write that in the array. So 13 has become green and 10 has also become green. Okay. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the next node. Next node is 8 and G, right? So next node is 8 and G. So I have the node 8 with the color green. Okay. So I will check the neighbors of 8. Let me clear this out. I have 8 with green color. So let me check its neighbors. It has two neighbors. Okay. 7. 7 is opposite color. Red. Right. So this is fine. This is not a problem. But there is a neighbor 10. Now this neighbor 10 is already having green color. Right. In the array also we have seen. And we have already given it green color. It's already having green color. So this is a problem. Right. This is a problem. Because we want to give it opposite color. Because see, it's near to a node that is having green color. So we wanted to give it red color, but before we could give it red color, we saw that it already had green color. So this is a problem. This means it's not a bipartite graph, right? So that is a simple algorithm. We'll apply simple BFS. Okay, you can apply simple BFS for this. Now what if you are going to apply DFS, right? You can also apply DFS. So let's quickly see some example for DFS and then we'll move forward to seeing the code. Okay, so you can solve it using both the methods. Okay, let's quickly see the DFS based approach for bipartite graph. So what we are going to do, we are going to take one node. We are going to, let's say, make it red. Then we are going to call its neighboring nodes. But in the DFS approach, when we'll call one neighbor, we'll go deep down into that neighbor itself. Okay, let's say we call this neighbor. Okay, so it was already red, so we can't make it red, right? We have to make it green. So let's say we give it some other color and then we call the neighbors of 2. Okay. Now we call the neighbors of 2. So what we'll do? So we'll make 4 as red because 2 is green, right? So 4 has to be red. And then we'll call the neighbors of 4. Okay, we'll call the DFS for 4. And 4 will try to call its neighbors. Now, when 4 is calling its neighbor 1, what does it see? It sees that its neighbor is already red. This is a problem, right? Because it is also red and its neighbor is also red. So this is a problem, right? So its neighbor is also red. It is also red. So this is not a bipartite graph. Okay, that is a simple logic. Now let's quickly see the code. So we'll see both the BFS and DFS code. So let's see the BFS code first. So basically we are taking a color vector that is used to represent the colors. Okay, so it just consists of 0 and 1. Okay, so let's say 0 represents red color and let's say 1 represents green color. So you can take any two colors which are represented by numbers. Okay, just we can represent it using different strings also, but just numbers are easier. Let's just take two simple numbers, 0 and 1. Okay, now let's initially give minus 1 to everything. That means it is uncolored. If it is minus 1, it doesn't have any color. Now we are doing this for loop. Why are we doing this for loop? Because graph can be disconnected. It is not necessary that graph is an entire connected component. There can be 2-3 different components. Even if one of them is not bipartite, you have to return false. So that's why we're doing this for loop. Whenever a graph is uncolored, we are going to go and visit all its neighbors, entire component actually. We are going to visit all the component of that graph, right? Whenever it is uncolored. If it's a single graph, this will happen in one time itself. It will color everything. But if it is a graph that is that has unconnected components, you have to keep calling this, right, for all the values in the nodes. Okay, and then you have to just go and check the bipartite, check if a graph is bipartite or not. So basically let's see this function bipartite. Okay, if this is false, then we'll return false overall. So let's check this function. So basically first we are doing the BFS approach. We are taking a queue, we are pushing the first node in the queue, right? So when we are pushing the first node, we'll give it any color. Let's say we are giving it the color 0. Okay, you can also give it 1 here, but let's just give it any random color. Let's say we are coloring it red. So next time we'll color the neighbors green and so on. Okay. Let's say we are making it 0. So unless the queue is still having elements, okay, we have to just take the first element, extract the first element, and then we are going to just check it color. Now it will always be colored, right? Because first of all, for the source node, we have already given a color. Okay. Otherwise, whenever we are seeing next time nodes, right, next time we are already coloring them. So we'll see the code, but always before pushing it in the queue, we are always coloring them. So this color will always have some value. Okay, this color will always have some value. So now it is having some value, either 0 or 1. Okay, let's say it's having value 0, so then its neighbor should have only 1. Okay, if it's having 1, its neighbor should have 0. So that's what we have to check basically. So we'll just take color, okay, and then we'll take its neighbor. So this is the adjacency list representation. We are going to each of the neighbor, and then we are checking if the neighbor, okay, whether it is colored or not. So we are just giving if else statement. So if the neighbor is not 1, that means neighbor is already colored, right? Neighbor is already colored, because if it was not colored, it will be 1, but here it's not equal to 1. So neighbor is already having some color, so we have to check if that color that the neighbor is having, right, if the color of the neighbor is equal to the color of our node. So the color of our node is color, and the color of the neighbor we are getting from the color vector. If they are both same, if this is also red, this is also red, it's a problem, right? Two neighbors cannot have the same color, so we'll return false. Otherwise, okay, otherwise if the neighbor was not already colored, right, if the neighbor was uncolored before, then it's simple, right? You have to just assign it a color and push it in the queue. So you'll just assign it the opposite color. If your color is 0, you'll assign it 1. If your color is 1, you will assign it 0. Okay, so that is a simple algorithm, and we'll push it in the queue and we'll return true. So that's it. This is a simple BFS based algorithm. Let's just run this and then we'll see the DFS based algorithm. It's very similar. Instead of queue, we'll just make the recursive calls again and again. Let's just quickly submit this. So this is fine. Okay, now let us see the DFS based algorithm. So DFS based algorithm is also similar only. So first lines are similar. We are going to give everything as -1. We are again going to do the same call, just return the same code, the same for loop for disconnected graph. But here I am just taking a variable flag. Whenever flag becomes false, I'll return false, right? So basically I'm taking a variable flag which is initially true. If it is a non-bipartite graph, I'll make this variable flag is false, okay, and I'll return it. So when it will return to its parent calls, it will return flag. So if anytime flag becomes false, you can simply return flag. So I've just added that additional complexity. Otherwise, this code is just the same, just added an additional flag. Okay. Now we'll see this function for the DFS based code. So we'll extract the color and then we'll extract all of its neighbors. So that's what we are doing. X are the neighbors here. And now if neighbor is, let's say, already colored, right? It's not 1. It's already having some value. We'll check if the neighbor's color is equal to our color. If it is so, then we'll make flag is false and we'll also return. We need not go into further calls and waste our time, right? Because already we have found flag, which is false. So now next time what we'll do, we will come to this case. Okay. We'll come to this case. So here, whenever we are seeing color vector, okay, its color is equal to, if next time what we are going to do, we are going to assign the color to the neighbor, right? So if our color is 0, then we'll assign the neighbor 1. Otherwise, we'll assign the neighbor 0. Very similar as the BFS code. So just the same thing. We are assigning the value to the neighbor. If the neighbor was already colored and if it is matching with our color, we'll return false. Okay, otherwise, it's fine, right? We can let the neighbor have whatever color it has. Okay, so this is the condition if the neighbor was colored. If the neighbor was colored already, just two cases. One case is if it had our same color, then we should return false. If it doesn't have the same color as us, it's fine with us, right? Fine with us, no problem. Let it have whatever color, which is not our color. So it's fine. Okay, if it is not this case, right? That means our neighbor was not colored. Our neighbor was uncolored. That means we have to assign it the opposite color of whatever we have. So in this case, we'll just assign it the opposite color. And then we'll call this check bipartite function again. Okay? We'll call this check bipartite function again. And then finally, we'll return flag. Okay, so let me just compile and run this. Let me see if it's working. So there is some error, color vector and flag. So let me see what is the error that has happened. Flag is false, return false, if check bipartite. Okay, there is some problem here. Let me check what is the problem. What are they saying? No matching function for call to check bipartite. व्हाट चेक बाय टाइट फ्लैग इज फॉल्स इट डिडंट फॉल्स ओके लेट मी सी व्हाट हैज बिकम द एरर Okay, okay, this is the error. I have just okay. So the error is that here I have given an additional parameter v, which I should remove. Now it's fine, right? Now it's fine. Let me just run and see if the code is working fine. So this code is fine, right? Let me just submit and see if it's working. So it's working fine.